Hello everybody, I am NicoD. Today Hardcornel has announced a new SBC, the Odroid H2. It's totally different of what I expected it to be. I was following the Odroid forum for the announcements of these boards. I expected it to have a new ARM SoC, but it doesn't have an ARM SoC, it has got an Intel CPU instead. So let's go over the specs of it. So this beast packs an Intel Celeron J4105, a quad-core at 2.3 GHz. It's got an internal GPU, the Intel UHD Graphics 600. It's got two SODIMM RAM slots for up to 32 GB of RAM. But if I read the Intel specs, it says only up to 8 GB. So there's no RAM on this board itself. You will have to buy this yourself, so this will be an extra cost. It's got 4-lane PCIe 2.0 for NVMe storage. There's 2 gigabit Ethernet ports and there's 2 SATA ports on board, SATA 3.0. It's got 2 display outputs, HDMI 2.0, so at 4K, and a display port, so DP 1.2. So you can use multiple displays on these boards. There's also an eMMC socket. I believe it's the same eMMC as with the Odroid XU4 and with the C2. There are also 2 USB 3.0 ports and 2 USB 2.0. I think it's USB 2.0, I can't see it clearly enough on the picture. The Odroid H2 will come with a big heatsink. According to their tests, it will not throttle even when maxed out, it will stay at 2.3 GHz with a temperature of 70 degrees Celsius. I expected an Intel chip to be very power hungry, but it clearly isn't. At idle, it only consumes 4 watts. When the CPU is maxed out, it's 14 watts. And with the CPU and the GPU combined, it's 22 watts. It can be powered with a voltage of in between 14 and 20 volts. So this will be a very nice single board computer. It will have some great advantages. The biggest advantage will be the driver support will be better than with an ARM chip. There will not be a struggle to get your YouTube playback to work in Chromium or to get games to work. So this is a great advantage against ARM chips. The biggest disadvantage for me will be the price. This board will be expensive. The CPU alone costs $100, so this board will be more than $100. I expect it to be between $150 and $200. The other ports except the CPU don't cost that much on the board, so they can keep it under $200. But this is of course without the RAM. I totally did not expect an Intel chip to be in an Odroid, but since 2015 they have been experimenting with different chips. Until now they were not so happy with the results, so they did not bring out any x86 boards until now. But with this chip, they are very happy. The performance is very good. The power consumption is very low. So it seems to have everything a good SBC needs these days. Odroid has got one of the best communities there are. So I expect it to have a lot of support. And certainly for games, this will be a beast. I've seen Nintendo Wii emulation on this board. And it looks really awesome. So that's it. I wanted to let you all know about the Odroid H2. So it's gonna be a real great board. Normally I would not be that interested in an Intel SBC, but for Odroid I'm willing to make an exception. I love the XU4 and I love the C2, so they are really good at what they do. So I think this board will be awesome. See you all later, thank you for watching, please like my video, subscribe to my channel, bye!